Good morning, everyone. We are starting our program for today. Please have the patience to be bearing with us for some of our technical glitches. Let's start. In every get together, we recall the old us. Some start with cheers, some light, the fire, some signal, the same old secrets gestures. Some try the nostalgic, the old familiar rhyme. Some tell account of their gray hair and how wrinkles change with time. Some find a very good reason to smile. Some smile in support, memories of once upon a time. A very warm welcome and a very good morning to all our attendees out there, our fellow GC citizens, respected professors, lovely seniors, and all my dear juniors. I, Deba Roti, on behalf of our entire GCECT family, take the honor to welcome you to our most awaited event of our alma mater this year, GCECT Alumni Meet and Webinar 2021, taking place amidst our new normal. Thank you to each and everyone for being here with us today. You would recall around the same time each year, we are holding our gala event for the industry, the National Symposium. On 25th January 2020, we hosted our very successful 4th National Symposium. On 25th January 2020, we had held it at the Pride Hotel. So today, after we are pandemic struck, we are again gathering here to restart the Grand Festival of the Alumni over the online mode with a grand thought-provoking webinar ushering in our much awaited 5th National Symposium to be organized very soon in person. But your support is all we need. With this spirit, let's get started. I would like to express our sincere appreciation for giving us this opportunity to conduct this event on your behalf. Firstly, I would like to welcome our president to start the session with his address. I would like to thank Prashantada to start the session. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Devaruti. Very good morning to all of you. On behalf of GCECT Alumni Association, I welcome all of you at this first web conference and a virtual alumni meet. So far, at least, I have not heard about the kind of virtual alumni meet from any alumni association. Probably this is the first time some alumni association is conducting the virtual meet of their association. You know, while conceptualizing of this kind of web meet, we the organizing committee was a little bit hesitant. But finally, today we are reconnecting, restoring, reinvigorating the GCECT and spirit. As a commission, every year we organize this kind of national symposium and alumni meet on the last Saturday of January. And this year also, we thought that we will do it. In 2020, when the national symposium was held, probably that was the last conference in a massive scale in the field of ceramics combined with computer science and IT. And we thought that probably we'll be the first to start it again with our symposium and alumni meet. But due to the pandemic situation, we are a little bit hesitant and we were thought about our seniors, all the attendees, so that they can take care of their health and safety properly. So this year, to organize this 5th National Symposium on this day with physical mode, we had to postpone. There was no other option. And I am sure that very soon we will announce the physical meet and we will organize the 5th National Symposium and our alumni meet again this maybe probably the second half of the year. And I'm sure that probably we'll be the first one to restart this kind of conference in the field of ceramics with combination of computer science and IT. And of course, by adapting new normal. So once again, a warm welcome to all of you and stay connected as we have a very interesting program throughout the day. Though it is very challenging for all of us, though we are conducting many web conferences like this, but our country is not that much equipped with the connectivity and adaptability of this IT system, foolproof IT system. So we may face some issues time to time, but even then, I pray that we will. And again, I warmly welcome all of you to this event. Please stay with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Prashantoda. It's always very lovely to hear from you. We all have a passion for our institute, a passion to unite and energetically add value. With such a connect with our alma mater, we are thriving as alumni today. We are fortunate to have with us Dr. Professor Krishnendu Chakraborty sir, the chief patron of GCCT alumni, and I request our respected principal sir to say a few words.
Good morning. I find myself fortunate and privileged to be part of glorious GCCT. In this pandemic situation, this shows your commitment to the institute and spirit of GCCTN. The theme of today's conference is also thought-provoking and well thought. It is titled as Reconnecting, Restoring, and Reinvigorating the GCCTN Spirit. I just went little deep to find word by word meaning of those four words. Reconnect, it means re-establish a bond of communication or emotion. Restore, it means to bring back to or put back into a former or original state. Reinvigorate means give new energy or strength. Spirit means mood or attribute of person. We are also in the same tune of this theme. We also want that all members of GCCT family to re-establish the bond with full vigor and strength so that the name and fame of this 80 years old institute spreads throughout the globe. At the same time, we also wish that the bond all members of the alumni becomes strong and stronger. To aid, we may increase the interaction in many ways so that we remain connected throughout the year. The pandemic situation has taught us many things. We have learned to continue our academics and other activities with the aid of technology. We have created facilities for those activities in digital mode. We are now in a position to take advantage from online mode. And according to me, this is a blessing in disguise. Our alumni also conduct and delivered lectures on a topic of their expertise to our faculties and students during this pandemic situation. It has enriched the whole community with new ideas and practices. We were immensely benefited from them. I also want year-long activities with our alumni in a pre-scheduled manner. We can have workshop, seminars, discussion in a scheduled manner. We can also organize many competitions, as for example, debate, quiz, technical paper writing, technical model preparation, etc., in a collaborative manner with the institute and the alumni association. I always say, more often we meet, more close we become. Those activities will help us to become close, and this is in tune with the theme of today's conference. I also welcome you all to this day-long event. I also wish the event a grand success. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to be with you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Your answers will surely help us grow. You are very motivating to us all the while. And now we have a small obituary session. Goodbyes hurt when the story is not yet finished and the book has been suddenly closed forever. Losing someone is a very irreparable loss, and a sudden demise is very hard to be dealt with. We lost some of our beloved alumni in a very short span. Mr. Prashanta Kumar Jana of 1996 batch recently. He was serving in the marketing department in TRL Kurosaki. He was a person of very amiable personality, but he has rose to success in his career in a very short time. We also lost Mr. Pradyut Mukherjee of 1988 batch. We all remember his very lively singing performances on our alumni cultural function 2 years back. We lost our senior Mr. Alok Sharkar, 1975 batch. He was the head of BRL IFICO, then SRU and ISV, from where he finally retired. With a very heavy heart, I request everyone to observe a minute of silence and pay some homage and peace for the departed souls. Please. Thank you. The session is over. We are looking forward to the next session. We, the people, believing in the possibility of a more perfect union, stood at the precipice of pandemonium and fought for a palpable peace. We stitched together a quilt of hope out of every fiber of our being. We juxtaposed our journey with a history of healing. We organized for all types of equality. We had restructured our economy, uprooted the false ontologies and toxic ideologies. We, the people, loved each other like the broken skin of a god, and by disarming any disease to our true democracy, we beat the odds. We, the people, faced our flaws and became critically conscious about our collective care. We did not back down in the face of bigotry or waver under the fallacies of fear. A very healthy lifestyle is the greatest blessing that we are not always granted with, but we must take care of. It is the main source of all the happiness of someone's life. Money can help you bringing all the luxuries in the world, but good health is something that you have to reward always. For being good well-being and happiness, it is important to switch a very healthy lifestyle. In this session, I request the Iron Man Colonel Prabir Sengupta to bring his health and lifestyle talk on physical fitness and mental robustness amidst the global pandemic time. For the GCCT alumni, Mr. Sengupta needs no introduction. His patronage with us over the years across the national symposiums held so far have made him our alumni in spirit. We were so much motivated, sir. Over to Mr. Prabir Sengupta, sir. Please start, sir.
Thank you so much, Devarati. A very good morning to all the alumni, the faculty, the esteemed teachers, and the dearest of students. Devarati, can I request the administrator to permit me share of this video, please?
Yes, sir. They are doing their best.
Okay.
You don't want to share, right? So I'm giving you an option, Colonel Sengupta, so that you can share it also.
Yes, okay, please.
Just give us a few minutes.
It is nice to see tearful, young, bright faces all across the panel.
Wow.
And as always, thank you. So you are another presenter.
Colonel Sengupta.
I got it.
I have given you the share of screen.
Is my screen visible?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Thank you so much. As always, it is always a pleasure to come back to the Alumni Association to your national symposiums and address wonderful students and faculties of this amazing, esteemed institution. I can just about understand how the last year may have been, gone through, and we've spoken enough about what the pandemic has done, how everyone has been impacted, affected, and so on and so forth. Therefore, my clarion call to all the participants in this would be, if you remember this famous quote by late Captain Vikram Batra, Paramveer Chakra, "Dil mangi more." And when we speak of reconnect, restore, and reinvigorate, I think if the clarion call that I just shared of "Ye dil mange more," you'll be able to put this caption in all these three statements: reconnect, I want more; restore, I want more; reinvigorate, I want more. And the moment the spirit of the GCCTs that is there, that I've seen, felt, the way you all connect with each other, connect with your esteemed institution, having already passed out for so long, I think the spirit is truly alive and kicking. And I kudos to everyone for organizing this symposium. And like Sir said, first of its kind of alumni association taking this initiative and connecting with everybody. Congratulations to everybody and a very good morning. I was told that during the pandemic, we had certain issues, and of course, the pandemic also brought to focus the importance of health. The way we were, some of us have been, very kind to our bodies and put on some additional kgs at places which we didn't require. Now, the foodies of us, took over, and we just added. Some of us, of course, went on doing things the way they have always done things. And therefore, I know the COVID has thrown up such vocabulary amongst us, and now we are talking of a new normal. The moment you say Netflix, everyone is thinking of the chess, the gambit, and so on and so forth, arias, and right. And everyone is now, social distancing has become, it's come in our vocabulary, right? And so on and so forth. Along with these kind of words and Zoom meetings and now web, Cisco web meeting, I also believe there were a lot of positives that were thrown in. the positives. Like, you remember 2 years, 1 year, 2 years back, we all said, sir, our work-life balance has gone for a six. We don't have time for our families, work, and so on and so forth. You know, the entire universe together sent a message to the good Lord saying that, you know, we need more time with our family. What did God say? Tathastu. And he says, be packed with your families. You know, after 1 year, now 9 months, 7 months, everyone said, God, enough. And the youth, I can just understand. I have a young daughter now, right? They are now saying, sir, come nikle baar. But yes, this I found it a tremendous positive, the way we connected with our family. Our lifestyles have undergone a change. Hygiene has come into focus, right? Everyone was, initial days, everyone is carrying those sanitizers, and given a chance, they are just, you know, going overboard. Some of them said, you know, the sanitizer has an alcohol content. Why don't we consume it inside? And then we may be sanitized from all across. You know, ideas were floating. You know that those kind of things happen. Environment underwent a change. In fact, the first 3 months of our COVID, there were total zero vehicles on the road. The environment underwent a change. There were new opportunities that threw up. You know, you see the kind of e-commerce. They've nearly doubled their revenue. A work from home has now turned mainstream, and a number of companies are saying we should be working mainstream, work from home, so on and so forth. There were nature, gardening is taken a forefront. I've seen so many people trying out hands on in the kitchen, and some of the ladies not quite happy that their, you know, better halves or bigger halves have come and started, you know, dominating their private space. Pets, I have personally, I've got this person, small little kitten at my house. Right now, and we are calling it Puchu. So Puchu is there in our life, and it has turned our lives around. And I therefore see the tremendous positives thanks to this pandemic. Yes, there are negatives, but if you keep speaking of the negatives, just the negative, right, it doesn't help me grow. I can see the positives that are happening, because I am a soldier. I see things the way they are. I'm a realist. I believe these are the qualities that you know, imbibed in a soldier. I see that. But something which is not quite mentioned is the physical fitness and mental robustness of a Fauji. Let me just share with you certain things of what makes us tick. Why do you, on the street, when you see a soldier or a gentleman, and say, you're Fauji hoga, why do you say that? It, what makes them tick, right? We undergo tremendous training, and it could be, you know, the 40 kilometer runs or the 10 mile run, so on and so forth. Firing, physical fitness is of prime in our daily schedule, and you can understand why. You've seen the kind of conflagration that is happening in the northern borders, right across with our eastern adversaries. If we were not physically fit, could we have sustained ourselves in those kind of temperatures, right? And therefore, those mountainous terrain that we are, you know, climbing up and down. So physical fitness is prime in the job that we do. Mental robustness, unless I visualize and train under various situations, my mindset, my, what you call it as, you know, your memory, muscle memory, they have to be attuned to what we are talking about. You would see on the right top corner a photograph of our commando run, and right after this run, this was a 40 kilometer run. This photograph must have been around 2:33 in the morning. The run begins at 7 o'clock. Why do we undergo this commando training? Right. It tells us that you and your body can sustain anything. You can undergo anything. There's no pain. And this is what some of you also call the runner's high, right? Endorphins and so on and so forth, dopamine. We'll go to the selfish, the feel-good hormones and the selfless feel-good hormones that will decide, right? You see the kind of training that we do. Commandos tells us, like I said, there is no ego. You could be a major, you could be a captain, you could be a lieutenant, you could be a first-class gazetted officer in the Indian Army. But when it comes to training, there is nothing that is beyond training. And therefore, I realize the pandemic has thrown up these challenges and health, mental robustness. Because a lot of people have met across this spectrum who have said, sir, we have lost it here. Sir, stress, sir, this. And it is all about your mind. So when you speak of physical fitness, along with it, in the Indian Army, in the armed forces, we always and always speak of mental robustness. Physical fitness is fine. Some of you are active physically and do a lot of things. What about your mental strength? How do you train that? Does the Indian Military Academy or the training institutions where you and I join as a fresher, and when we come out, what is the process that they put you through that your mental robustness and your mental well-being is taken care of? What is this process? Let me try and share. Have you coped with this new normal? How many of you have coped it? Has it been good? Right. So how do you handle these challenges? Failure is a word I should have to, not use here, but how do you use these challenges, the issues that have cropped up? Just think of this photograph that is there behind. This time, right this time when this photograph was taken, the temperature would have been around roughly minus 12, 15. The breeze is not visible, so the wind chill factor is not seen by you. It pierces through your bones, right? And of course, there is oxygen is not there, so you are breathing heavy. So the walking, even the walking, normal walking is strenuous. You have to take a break after every 10 steps, 20 steps. How do you handle these challenges? Well, I believe it comes from your belief systems. What do you believe? And you remember, what you are telling yourself comes out of your belief system. What is the belief system? And therefore, you need to look at your belief system. What do you believe in? Right? Do you believe X, Y, Z, or do you believe no, it is possible? Because sometimes, some way back, maybe, way, way, way back, you were in fifth standard, sixth standard, and the first time you were told to make a speech or a debate, or, you know, the teams were being selected for your elocution competition in your school, and you were told, nah, tumi korbe na, or tumar dhara hobe na, or whatever. And that belief system till now, you're stuck with ami kotha bolte parbo na, and therefore you're stuck with stage fright. Think of that small elephant, baby elephant, you know, tied with that rope. Now it has become a giant of an elephant, but it cannot. Its belief system says, the rope, I cannot break the rope. This is the belief system that elephant is. Now, do you therefore agree that you need to constantly look at, I'm not saying change it every time, look at your belief systems, work at your belief system, and this starts with your self-belief. The second time or the fifth time you were not able to do your maths sum, say the theorem, right? And you believe that maths amar dhara hobe na, or think worse to that effect. So what is this? How do you strengthen your self-belief? How do you strengthen it? Well, to strengthen your self-belief, itself comes from your experiences. I'll give you an example. Say Devarati is there. Now in her 10th standard, she studied hard. She went for her exams and got a good 90%. I hope you got 90%. Right. So she gets a 90%. What is her self-belief? Padho, mehnat karo, I get, work hard, and without compromising anything, I am able to get a 90%. Her belief system says, work hard, you get results. If had there been a fault, say she had worked hard and not got the 90, her belief system would have been, kodlo ki chuhayna, or, sir, you know, and then you come up with number of excuses why it didn't happen, or why it doesn't happen, right? This is the first time when your belief systems start taking shape. And therefore, you need to look at your belief systems. I will just quickly share what are my belief systems. On the right hand side, you will see those what we now call as Bangla cycles. On the extreme right is my photograph way back. This, those days, understand, we didn't have this technical photographs and, you know, mobile phones and things. This was a photograph taken just prior to our Bombay to Delhi cycling expedition. Way back, right? This was about 82, I think, right? Or 81, 82. Right. On the left, you will see I was in the boarding school and we were the prefects of the school. So my belief systems are getting, you know, shaped. Bottom, you'll see a photograph of Rajouri. This was the first time I went on a trek from Rajouri across the Pir Panjal Wind to Srinagar. My belief systems are taking shape. And then, of course, it was the defense forces where I was in the infantry and terrorists or what we call militants, taking them down, which was part of our job. You know, my belief system therefore says, I am better trained than him, and therefore I will dominate him. I will neutralize him. There's no question that he can do any other way. Right, these are my belief systems. On the right, you'll see a young captain, Prabir Sengupta. That time was an instructor in Indian military academy. So my belief system gets, now can you see how the belief systems take shape? Right, I see that you work hard, you'll be nominated instructor. On the left top corner, you'll see we were in the Rashtrapati Bhavan with President Kalam. This is a ceremonial battalion. What are the experiences I'm going through, which will shape, of course, the bottom corner is the operations that we were in one of the cities in Srinagar. Right, and so, of course, our training and those kind of stuff that go into, not very many people besides the defense forces would have experienced this kind of vast experiences. Chopper training, exercises, snowbound, or sea, you name it, right? And of course, on the left top corner is right where we were in the thick of things, right behind that hill that you see. Mountains across that is our western adversary, Pakistan. This was in Kupwara district, and operations happening. Right? And for all those actions that I had participated in, on the right, you will see me being facilitated by the Vishesh Seva Medal. What I'm trying to get at, your experiences will define your belief systems. Right top corner were the five of us who had gone for a 100-kilometer run to cycling run to Singur and back. Right bottom, experiences with President Kalam. See, the moment you have such kind of experiences, this is what I finished my year with. On the 31st of December, 53 kilometers. On the right was the first ride of this new year, 2021, 50 kilometers again, right? And you can see the average speed I increased from 17 kilometers to 20 kilometers. So my belief system says, push yourself, keep health top priority. You will be able to do things. You will be able to sustain. That will give you the facility to play golf, visit, say, Andaman in this case, and address such esteemed August gathering like I'm doing with you all. Now, that goes to develop ourselves to live a life less ordinary. And I deep down believe each one of you who are there in this platform have been destined to live a life less ordinary. You have to push up. You'll have to look at your belief systems. You have to improve your self-belief. This morning, this very morning, I was speaking to SSP, they call him SS Chaurasia, is the number one golfer in India. And he says, sir, we were talking of the last, just Abu Dhabi Open last Sunday, and Hutton was putting. And he says, sir, how do you putt that? Because your hands start shaking, because that putt could cost you roughly 10 million or 20 million, because it will be the difference between being first or second. And there is 50 million prize money or 10 million prize money. So it's a 40 million putt you're putting. How do I say, SSP, it is about self-belief. How does self-belief develop? I will touch upon that just shortly. And that will give you the confidence, ye jayega andar, it will go in. Right? How do you develop this self-belief? Our self-belief came from our military academy, where we had this motto from our Indian military academy, Sir Philip Chetwood. Safety, honor, and welfare of your country come first. Always in it. Your own honor, welfare, and comfort of your men come next. And your own ease, comfort, and safety come last. Always every time. And this is imbibed in every officer of essence forces. And therefore, a lot of people ask, how did you do what you did? Well, we did this because there was this motto that always guided us. It was there in the back of our mind. Right. You would say, sir, therefore, all this here, kahani hai, how does it help us? Well, this as a lifestyle tweak, I have seen work for me. I just see, you all have done things. When I say Devarati, I also mean everyone, right? You all have done things. And you have seen some working, some not working. My plea to you all is, try this for 1 week. See, in 21 days, sanskar banta, habit ban jata hai. Right? Give yourself a chance to succeed. Imbibe this lifestyle tweak for this 1 week, coming week, and you'll see things happening. There are reasons why I say this. Right? Early morning, when you get up, go out. When I say out, I want fresh oxygen in your body. This will energize you. This morning, I had your 9 rounds of golf, 9 holes, 2 hours walking in fresh oxygen. Nothing can, you know, change this. Outdoor exercise, to be walk, run, cycling, yoga, do anything. Some, a lot of people find excuses. Sir, humare ukhanta jaga nahi. Sir, humare yahan jaga nahi. Arre chhat hai tumhare boss. Niche society ke wahan compound hai. Bahar chale jao, road mein chale jao. Yahan pe 2 lake hai, joda 2 lake. You know, go anywhere. And nowadays, some of you, like I was speaking this morning to Jaydeep sir, actually New Town area, that Salt Lake area, they have developed it so much. I go down to the Godrej waterfront. It is one of the most beautiful places in Calcutta. I'm not speaking of Eco Park. These are the areas, early morning, fresh oxygen, nothing will eat that for your energy, for oxygen in your body. Have a good night's sleep. Your body has been designed for 7 hours of sleep, roughly. Right? If more than that, you're wasting your life. Less than that, you may function not quite optimally. We have been trained for around 5.5 to 6 hours, 6 hours of sleep. Go to bed by 10, 11. Try this out. The moment you sleep at 10, 7 hours, and thereafter your day starts. I know some of them are laughing. So Netflix is our khatam hota 3 baje, 2 baje. I can see the smile playing in a lot of people's, right? Try this. Some of you say, sir, raat ko padhte hain. See, your productivity will go up 3 times if you do your studies early morning, because that's when your brains are fresh to absorb. And therefore, these are proven facts I'm talking about. The moment you sit to study at night, what happens? The moment you open your book, and why was the girl smiling to you? Why did the teacher kick me off? Why was this crowd? Why did mom give me this? Why did this? And the whole day's video starts playing in your mind, and then you miss out. Your productivity goes down. Your focus is not so much there. Right? Invest in your self-growth. Invest in self-development. It could be online courses. There is no bar to studying. My sister, she must be 70 in coming month. She has just completed her Dutch studies because her grandson is in Amsterdam who speaks to her in Dutch. Because he's a chota sa bachcha, wo Dutch mein baat karta hai. My sister wants to speak to her, so she's learned Dutch. Right? I'm learning Spanish. You have to do something to keep you. Have your personal goals and professional goals. It is not just having it. My request would be, write it down. 5 small personal goals. 5. And don't say, I want to be healthy. No. Give it, be specific. I want to lose weight because of ABC, or I want to be 79 kgs by so and so. Give yourself a date. I want to make 1 lakh rupees per month. Give a specific date. Don't say, I want to be rich. I want to be happy. I want to be healthy. These are vague statements. Right. Love your work. Maintain a healthy work-life balance. Life will be good. Check these things. You'll say, sir, as a kaise hota, because if you need to be a successful leader, my one word would be, take a guess. Devarati, take a guess. What would that word be?
Sir, resilience.
Resilience. I would have said attitude. Resilience can be built if I had a positive attitude. In the sense, anything else all boils down from attitude. Whether you have a positive attitude, negative. The same COVID impacted everybody, yet some of them came out bright and shining, smiling. Some of them were depressed. Sir, mar gaye, lut gaye, you know, and all those kind of stuff. Why? It all boils down from this one word called attitude. How do you develop a positive attitude? Right? These are recommended ways, 7 recommended ways of, you know, you have to replace have. I have to go there. Have to put pressure. I need to get there. You immediately see there is no pressure. Avoid these negative people. Notice the right, even wrong things. Kahin na kahin achha ho raha. Feel good about things. In fact, build self-esteem. Stop being a victim. Find a goal. The moment you find a goal, it will drive you towards that direction. Find an inspiration. Kiske liye kar raha hai? A lot of smokers, young boys, smokers. Say, sir, koi mila nahi bolne ke liye, ab tak cigarette chhod do. Hello. What a... Find an inspiration. Stay away. Stay focused. And let me ask you, what is your self-talk? When I say self-talk, what do I mean? What do you tell yourself each morning? One.
Aaj kya baar Zoom meeting ache.
Two. Oh, to Zoom meeting to ho jabe. Tarpor I'll do this, then I'll do this. Then, how do you see yourself? Do you? And you can immediately make out how your brain reacts to both these statements. Right. Because I believe our life is a matter of our attitude. Positive attitude will positively create chain reactions of positive thought. Achok aadmiyon ke saath to bura ho hi nahi sakta hai, boss. Positive thoughts will produce positive results. There's no question. This is proven. This is physics. Equal and opposite reaction. The first law of physics or third law of physics, some of them, right? Equal and opposite reaction. Now, some of them said, sir, but under these depressing times, how do we have, how do we feel self-motivated? Karne ka jee nahi karta hai, sir, and all those kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying, right? Now, if you want to ask yourself, how do you need to be self-motivated? Ask yourself these 3 questions. Can you do it? Will it work? Is it worth it? Just these 3 questions. I know the question may sound vague, but can you do it? Say you want to climb Mount Everest. Say, can you do it? Yes, I can. Will it work? I don't know. I'll have to try. Is it worth it? Of course it is worth it. This is one example of, say, Everest. I want to pursue, say, engineering, or you know, I want to become a doctor. Again, anything you want to do, put these 3 questions. And then it comes to something called, can you do it, comes from self-efficacy. Let me take 2 minutes just to explain what is self-efficacy. This is a word which most of you have. Okay, I'll ask you a question. The photograph in this was of Dada, what we call Dada. And Dada was very, the sobriquet he had earned was God of offside. Right? Now, think of it. The first time Dada went to play that offside drive, did he strike the ball neatly? Maybe, may not be. Second time, third time, fifth time, to shayad out bhi hua hoga. What happened is, he kept doing that, kept doing it. And his muscle memory, the neural connections, started getting stronger and stronger. And the myelin around those neural connections, thereafter, it became something like his second nature, what we call second nature. His muscle memory took over. Ball comes here, go for this drive, it will be a 4. And slowly, he became God of offside. This is self-efficacy. The moment you work on self-efficacy, what happens? Now think of it. Devarati has run 3 marathons now. Now I'm talking of self-efficacy. What is your self-esteem? There is someone comes and tells her a marathon dorna. What is the self-belief? Ho jayega. Why? Sir, abhi to dauda hun. Right? What is self-esteem? You feel good about yourself. What is the self-belief? Self-belief, self-esteem, self-motivation. Everything else gets addressed the moment you improve or work on your self-efficacy. And self-efficacy is nothing but लगे रहो मुन्ना भाई. एंड वेयर कैन यू बी लगे रहो मुन्ना भाई इन समथिंग विच यू लव टू डू विच यू आर पैशनेट अबाउट. सो बी वेरी केयरफुल विथ वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू डू. दैट इज द मूड क्वेश्चन. एंड देयरफॉर यू द मोमेंट यू थिंक ऑफ इट डू हैव टाइम जिसके लिए अच्छा लगता है ना विल फाइंड टाइम. Knowledge and training you will get, right? So can you do it? Will it work? Of course it will work. If you work on your self-efficacy, your beliefs, your attitude, everything will happen. It will work. Yes, and it can't come back. Of course it can't come back, right? And is it worth it? Naturally, if I'm unfurling the flag on top of Mount Everest, it is worth it, buddy. It is worth it. When I complete 100 kilometers and come back, it is worth it. I feel good about it. My endorphins are, you know, top of the line. So, the moment you want to be self-motivated, look at these three things and you will naturally, if the answer is yes, you will be self-motivated. You will feel empowered. You have made a choice. This is the Odia girls football team. Yes, in sari, that won the young something in England. Right? I was so proud that. Therefore, I always put this as a background photograph to show, look at the smiles and the cheer because they have achieved something, accomplished something. Kuch karne ke liye, you know. Now people say, how do you motivate? Repattern your self-talk. Visualize the reward and therefore believe in yourself. And that will, right, help you. And some of you may look at this as jnan. Believe me, the moment you imbibe even 10 of these statements, you see a change in your lives. डर के आगे जीत चौधरी खड़ा है ना. जीत क्या? जीत, राइट ना. देयरफॉर बिलीव मी व्हेन आई से हैप्पीनेस इज नॉट टू गेट व्हाट यू लाइक. मेरे को ये बहुत पसंद है, मेरे को मिल गया, दैट विल नॉट बी हैप्पी. आई वांट आईफोन, मिल गया आईफोन, दैट विल नॉट. हैप्पीनेस इज टू लाइक व्हाट यू गेट. यू गॉट मैरिड, योर हस्बैंड, योर वाइफ, दैट लाइक इट. Otherwise, there will always be distraction. And therefore, I believe as is so. So invest where your energy goes, your attention goes, things will grow. I understand when I say all these things, you'll because remember, whatever you think, that becomes your actions and those becomes your habit. Therefore, your destiny is what you think you become. Right? You become what you think about. Therefore, be careful with your thoughts and where it will lead. Therefore, I said, Siddhi se Srishti. Pure world ne Siddhi ki thi. Is God work-life balance, family time. Atastu, Srishti. Right? Siddhi se Srishti. Whatever you think, it materializes unfortunately or fortunately. And therefore, be careful with what you are thinking. Because I believe, sanskar se hi tumhare sansar banta hai. Your sanskar is healthy lifestyle. Your sanskar says, wake up in the morning. Your sanskar says, you know, smile, laugh, live life. All those positive words. Sanskar hai tumhara. This is imbibed. Ye mere DNA mein hai. Usse mera sanskar kaisa hoga? Sanskar se. I know, ye aap log bolenge, kya glib words there hai sir. Because I believe your destiny is led by your thoughts. It becomes your belief systems. And that can translate into action. Some of you may be seeing an old lady here in the words, in the photograph in the middle. Right? All those who are seeing an old lady, welcome to the club of 50 plus. All those who can see a young girl there, live life, king size. Right? Now you keep wondering what is it, whether this center photograph is an old lady or a young woman. Right? I believe. Each one of you need to ask yourself, what is my statement? If I ask you, say, Devarati, give me one statement to describe yourself. You know, it will become very difficult to go ahead. I'll give you an example. Under foreign domination for over two centuries, he galvanized the nation to overthrow a regime non-violently. Immediately, you know, I'm talking of, say, Mahatma Gandhi. Similarly, I'm talking of, say, Babaram Ambedkar. What is your statement?
So will I say?
Sorry?
So will I say?
No, no, I'm saying. So therefore, okay. Be able to define yourself in the statement and you will find a purpose. Because I believe this pandemic has shown, because everybody now realizes family first, health, nation. The moment you put these three things in the top of your priorities, things will fall in place. And when I speak of nation, I always remember this gentleman called Rakesh Sharma, Sare Jahan Se Achcha. And this is the quote I remember specifically, I used last time as well, when I said, Yunaniyo Misriyo Rome, sab mit gaye jahan se, phir bhi baki namo nisha humara. Kuch baat hai, ki hasti mitti nahi humari, sadir raha hai dushman, daure jahan humara. सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा. जय हिंद, जय हिंद. आई अंडरस्टैंड देयर वुड बी अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, लॉट ऑफ यू नो डाउट्स, सेल्फ डाउट्स. आई एम ओपन टू एनी. You can put it in the chat box or you can ask me. It will be a pleasure to speak to you, anybody at all. And I hope I have chosen my time frame that I was given.
It was amazing, Colonel, and it was a super inspiring talk from your end. And I would request if anyone has any, and because your contact is to with all of us, but the way you lit up our spirits, you fire our inner selves in such a charming way, we are really grateful to you. We also look forward to meeting you soon in person. And that was really a very appreciable talk from you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Devarati. Thank you so much for your more than kind words.
Thank you, sir. We would like to connect to you once again in person next time. We are looking forward to the next event now. Teachers have three loves: the love of learning, the love of learners, and the love of bringing the first two loves together. We are very blessed to have one of our alumni as our professor. So what more can we ask for? I am very proud to call upon our dear professor, Dr. Rituparna Sen sir, along with our beloved alumni and working president, Sumit Ghati, to coordinate our next session, the live update from alumni and the voice of alumni. Over to you both. Please continue.
Good afternoon, all attendees. Good afternoon, professors. Good afternoon, my students, my seniors. Welcome you to this new kind of webinar. I hope Sumit is already here. Sumit, could you connect? Am I audible? Am I audible? Devarati?
Yes. Audible, audible.
Yes, you are.
Okay, I hope Sumit will be connecting very soon. So let me start the session. So this is, before proceeding for the voice of alumni, we would have something, some live session. So before proceeding for that, I'll just share you with a few words. I was reading somewhere, it held my finger when I was an age and showed me how to grow. The all tough teenage years, it assisted my wisdom to grow. My parents gave me the roots, but the soil, heat and water, it fed. And for all fruitful days in life, I owe it to my alma mater. The strength with which I carry on, the confidence in my speech, is all because I sat in a world that taught me honesty, sincerity, and peace. Its memories are immortal, and the images linger in my heart. And though in life I'll move on, my school will always remain my sweetheart. Thank you. Would like to thank Mr. Colonel Sengupta for your most inspiring talk. I attended your live lecture also in our earlier sessions. So it was really nice to have you here. Thank you so much. I'd also like to thank our principal, sir, for giving the enlightening lecture in the initial period of the inaugural session. Now, I want to thank the Alumni Association who really worked hard to make this event successful. And thank you all attendees present here, for paying your attention and learning. Now, most interesting session, the live session, I would like to introduce our most noted alumni, Gautam Bardoloi, better known as GB of 1994 batch, who, other than being a very good entrepreneur, he had his own company, now had been contributing to social activities for the last 1 year. And what a fascinating experience. I would ask Sharbapi to share the screen with all of you so that you can have a glimpse. What miracle did he do? No sound, Sharbapi?
No, this is shared by Supriyo. Sound is very mild. We also can't hear.
Oh.
Let me play it.
Okay.
Please, we are.
Hello, not visible.
Yeah, we can't see your screen yet.
Is there any problem in sharing the screen, Sharbapi?
I think so, because it is shared by Supriyo from Government College of Engineering.
Yes, yes, Supriyo.
He is trying to get the sound, I think.
Oh, let's wait for a minute.
For a minute, I'm trying to set it up as soon as possible.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, this is a big challenge for all of us to conduct such kind of conference through a web platform. And, you know,
yes,
in our country, we are yet to, to be really equipped with such kind of connectivity. Even not only the connectivity, the software system, different person has got different kind of system, and if that is not adaptable, it is very difficult to connect each other.
It has also sometimes it depends on the bandwidth and the streaming of video with sound, and also a little bit of time problem might be there. So
yeah, there are some good things.
Rituja, can I suggest we go to the Voice of Alumni now?
Yes.
Supriyo manages the video, and after you end the Voice of Alumni session, before lunch, we'll show the two videos, right?
Sure. So, dear participants, so let us move to the Voice of Alumni session just prior to showing you the exciting work by Gautam Bardoloi and another noted alumni. Announce his name. This is none other than Shobhashachi Roy of 2003 batch. He had also done some exciting work and all. I will be having those things just after the Voice of Alumni. So let me put before you the Voice of Alumni. I would start calling some names of some noted alumni whom we could contact immediately for sharing their experiences about the Alumni Association how to proceed further, how to improve upon certain things so that we can reach out to more people. So what are their previous experiences in some 5 or 10 sentences within 1 or 2 minutes, maybe maximum 3 minutes. So I'll call upon some names and there will be after that some open session also. Whoever wants to talk very shortly, they can also share their views. First of all, I would like to invite our just immediate past president, Dr. Borundeb Mukherjee, to say a few words. Borundebda, would you please switch on your video and unmute yourself to talk a little bit on our association activities, because you had been the immediate past president. So let us hear it from you first and then proceed for many seniors and maybe many.
Can you hear me?
Yes, you continue.
Good afternoon, everybody. I've been very briefly, I will try to project before you that where this alumni association would like to go tomorrow. So to do that, we must know where we are today and where we were yesterday. See, this association started from sometimes in 2014, the idea was mooted. It started functioning in 2015. We have been organizing national symposium, technical seminars, and we also did health camps and job portals. This is where we are today. But I would just in one sentence tell me where we were in the last 50 years. If you look back, in the last 50 years, the Alumni Association did exist in some form or other, not as well organized as the current one, not as well, the activities were not as well undertaken as the current ones. But even in the Silver Jubilee in the 60s, or even in the Golden Jubilee in the 90s, or in the 21st century for a Platinum Jubilee, in all of them, you know, in different forms, all kinds of alumni associations were participated and helped. Earlier, the alumni association, what it did, it used to organize a cultural program and basically connect the alumni amongst themselves and to some extent with the students of the current members. So what I believe we would like to do tomorrow, continue in the same path, connect all the alumni of the GCECT alumnus and connect them with the members of the current GCECT, students, faculty members, and all others. This will remain one of our most principal and important objectives. But we would also like to serve to grow the college nationally and, if possible, maybe.
Borundebda, I think you have lost connectivity. So we have listened to our ex-president, just immediate past president, Dr. Borundeb Mukherjee. Let me now take you to because I am seeing on screen Dr. S.K. Banerjee. He is a very senior veteran nonagenarian, ceramist who had served many industries. He has served Central Glass and Ceramic Research Institute. He had been very closely associated with the college. I would request Sharbapi, can you share the screen? So can everyone see Dr. S.K. Banerjee on screen? So that just to have a glimpse of Dr. S.K. Banerjee, who has been very sick for the last few days. So let us see Dr. Banerjee.
Hello.
Dr. Banerjee, how are you?
Yeah, Rita Bono.
Yes.
How are you and all others? It's a great pleasure for me to be with you today. You see,
yes.
Padmapi brought me here.
Yes, yes.
I'm so glad that today's world has completely changed. But I can see you. I have seen the principal. I have
seen
all of us. And Padmapi has organized this.
Yes, yes. It really, Shantosda, it's really heartening to see you completely fit and sitting and talking to us, because you might remember I used to telephone you.
Yes. Completely fit. Yes. But then
yes.
I'm so happy to see you and
yes.
everybody here, the
yes.
principal and all other students.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Bless us. Bless everybody. With all your experiences, bless us so that we also
yes.
can do well in life.
Blessings
you also,
my you, and
you,
to all of you. You
remain happy and
you
safe.
20, 30 years.
Yes,
so
yes.
I would like to advise that all of you should be happy in life And
thank you.
All, you should change your attitude also.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Santosh. Thank you.
Bye
bye.
Bye
bye. Bye bye. So, you all could see Dr. S.K. Banerjee, who had been very much unwell for the last few months, I can say. But now, seeing him fit, it's really, really nice to see him fit and talking to us in this open platform. Now, I was seeing on screen Mr. Devesh Haldar. Oh, Devesda. Devesda is fantastic. Devesda of 1983 batch. So, I'd like to hear from Devesda a few words. Devesda, be comfortable with whatever language you can use. This is a voice of alumni. So whatever you want to share, Bangla te bolte paro, Hindi te bolte paro, Hindi te bolte paro, with your vigor and with your normal way of speaking, you just share something.
He can speak in Portuguese also.
Let it be a multilingual kind of thing,
okay.
Where that language of college also should be there. That's altogether a different language. It doesn't come in vocabulary, yes. Lekin wo bhi language hai. So actually, ye dudher sathe ghorer metachi. Kenona, when this committee was formed, this present committee, where a person like Prashanto, Dr. Rituponno, your Joydeep, Sarbapi, they are there. Actually, I expected personally that it will be a gala reunion this time. But because of this pandemic, we could not. That is okay. But at the same time, hats off to you all. The way this particular team has organized this, this is really exemplary for whole world, I should say. Because এইরকম রিউনিয়ন হতে আমি ইনফ্যাক্ট দেখিনি তবে হ্যাঁ আমি পার্সোনালি মিস তো করছি কেননা আমি বেসিক্যালি আমাদের যে কলেজের যারা থিঙ্কার আমি ঠিক থিঙ্কারদের দলে পড়ি না আমি অ্যাকচুয়ালি পড়ি এ ছাড়া যেটা ক্লিঙ্কার ড্রিঙ্কার অ্যান্ড অবভিয়াসলি দ্য থিঙ্কারস অলসো হ্যাঁ সাম পিপল আর ব্লিঙ্কার হ্যাঁ দে আর অলসো ভেরি ক্লোজ টু মি So I rather belong to that group of our college. That way I am missing. So let us all hope for the best that as early as possible we should have our A. And under the present committee itself, the committee should not change. If this pandemic goes on for coming 20 years, then also this committee should be there. Kyunki Prashantor to ekta khel ami dekhtei chai. Karona wo এত কিছু করছে অ্যাজ প্রেসিডেন্ট হ্যাঁ প্রশান্ত আছে বিথু আছে হ্যাঁ নাহলে রিউনিয়ন কি রিউনিয়ন মানে সামনাসামনি যদি না হাক করতে পারলাম তাহলে রিউনিয়ন কি উইদাউট হাগিং হয় বলে দিয়ে আরো অন্য সিনিয়র
থ্যাংক ইউ দেবেশদা থ্যাংক ইউ থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আমরা আমরা খুব শিগগিরই একটা মানে ফিজিক্যাল মিট এবং ওই ধরনের যেটা আমরা প্রোগ্রামটা করতাম সেদিকে আমরা ইয়ে করবো আমরা এটা আগে একটা টেস্ট কেস হিসেবে এই সময়তে আমাদের করার ছিল সেই এটা করলাম তারপরে আমরা আবার সেটা ভাববো সবাইকে নিয়ে আবার সেটা ভাববো আমি অন স্ক্রিন দেখতে পাচ্ছি সুদূর সৌদি আরবিয়া থেকে ইন্দ্রজিৎ ঘোষ পার্টিসিপেট করেছে So Indrajit, can you unmute yourself and put on your video and share your views? Indrajit Ghosh, who is in Zubay, Saudi Arabia. Indrajit Ghosh, 1991 batch. Indrajit.
Good morning, Ritoda and everyone. And
Morning.
To all the organizers and office bearers and all the alumni present, thank you all for arranging this, which is a very, a wonderful thing, all of this. I have nothing much to say. All of you are in the, right direction. One issue, what I thought that some of the alumni don't think that the alumni association is relevant or they should be engaged and all. So we have to, increase our, relevance to them. Things are changing, the world is changing, and we have to see how, we can add values and make everyone participating. And all of you are doing wonderfully well. Okay, and it is very heartening to see all the alumni spreading over all over the world. I can tell you, even in Saudi Arabia, in our company, there are 5. Okay, so we are all over the world. Okay, so thank you very much for this opportunity. Please carry on. Thank you.
Thank you, Indrajit. Keeping some time for us, because I know this is a working day in Saudi Arabia. So maybe you are attending office and then logging in to have a discussion with us. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining us. And you ask just ping Manavendra also. I don't see his on screen. He perhaps could not log in. So can you ask Manavendra to log in so that we can hear from him also? So now on screen, I am seeing Tridib Chakrabarti da. Tridib da from Saint-Gobain, great TKC, our employer. So and very highly enthusiastic person to have participated almost in all the alumni events we have organized so far from 2017 onwards. So Tridib da, please share something with us. How can we improve upon the activities? Is it a convenient time for holding, as we are holding in last week of January? I would like to know from each and every alumni whether there is any difficulty organizing this thing and your participation in these activities.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Unmute yourself. Unmute yourself. Put on your video. Thank you. Please.
Thank you. Thank you, Ritu. First of all, I am not the employer. My company, Saint-Gobain, is the employer.
No, you are the key person, Tridibda. You see, what you decide, that is decided by the company. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. First of all, I must give all my thanks to Ritu, to Prasanto, to Sarbapi, and all the organizing committee that in such a difficult situations, you have been able to conduct at the same day, because I can remember that every year on 30th only we are celebrating this. So it's always give me a very immense pleasure to talk, and I have also, whatever I have participated, I have given the speech, and it is always a very good feeling. I feel very honored and also very nostalgic to talk in this particular event. Because this is very, very important for us, because this is only the platform which has been provided and the opportunity to meet many of us together. I can remember, I have just missed the first alumni meet, but in second alumni meet, I was so delighted that after such a long period of time, I have met so many people, old people with whom I used to interact once upon a time, some of my batchmates. That was really fantastic. So according to me, actually, that this kind of alumni meet, it is always creates a special bond between the present students, those who are just passed out, and those who have already established themselves in a big outside world. It's a perfect platform that to meet all together, chat, informally, and to revive the contacts. So this is very, very important and important events, and I am looking forward that at the end of this year or in the next year we are meeting together. Whatever support will be there, I can extend, I will definitely do that, and I will urge others also to come forward. It is a fantastic event for the CCTNs, and this is in such occasions also the organizing committee and our team has not forgot that this has to be done. So thanks to the organizing committee for doing this, not only this year, for the last many years. And even the pandemic did not deter them to organize this.
Thank you, Tridibda.
But one more good thing I must talk about. This pandemic has actually gifted us one more thing, this virtual platform. which we never used so much before.
Yes.
I'm sure that we are going to meet sometimes at the end of this year. And also I say that we must come out from this present pandemic completely. And also I must say that the present students, they must not suffer. This yes. pandemic should not, you know, give an obstacles to their prospect and to their career.
Right. Like one thing, Tridibda, for your information and for everyone's information, in this pandemic, these final years, they could not be actually across India. These people could not be sent for in-plant training this year in May, June, July. So now I'm happy to announce that 23 students are taking in-plant training in December, from December to February. And people are also now going for this thing because we have autonomy with the permission of our principal and the academic regulation. We can send them for in-plant training in Dalmia OCL, in Piramal Glass, whatever, SRU SAIL, Tata Steel, everywhere they are taking training. So I'm very happy to announce that, and students are getting appointment also. One guy has already got in Piramal Glass. Interviews for calories is going on. So in pandemic situation also, students are not deprived to that sense. And our alumni are highly cooperating in that respect, and they are taking our students. So I'm very happy to announce.
Thank you, Ritu, because this is what is my this thing also, that the students, our students, must not be suffered.
Yeah. Thank you, Tridibda. Thank you.
Thank you all. Yeah. And wish you all to stay happy, healthy and safe. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. I'm seeing on screen one new name. Oh, what a surprise. Sudarshana Sanal of 1993 batch, if I remember properly. After so many years, 27 years, I have not seen her. Sudarshana, can you hear me? Can you unmute yourself and put on your video?
Yes.
Just say some few words. I didn't see you for 27 years. It's a long, long time. Please put on your video so that everyone can see. Yes, yes.
Great pleasure to see you, Rituda. I was so happy to see all of you. And I completely agree with Tridibda that, you know, I could not attend any of the reunions because of work and my family, managing a family. Being a woman is definitely a very different ball game, you know, balancing work and personal life. But this pandemic at least provided us this platform, virtual platform to connect with each other. And it's an absolute delight. I wish to continue attending these reunions. And I feel along with the physical reunion, we should also have this virtual reunion so that our reach is more. We reach out to many more students. And definitely, we should strive to develop, strengthen our bond with the present students and our seniors and our classmates. Of course, we are in WhatsApp group. And I can't express in words the kind of delight I'm getting today.
Thank you, Sudarshana. Thank you. It was so nice to see you. For everyone's knowledge, Sudarshana is now perhaps a global HR head of huge company. So from her words you can easily visualize her perception of life and position she's undertaking. Okay, thank you, Sudarshana. Thank you to be here. Okay, I'm seeing on screen Sharit Kundu. Sharit Kundu, are you there? Sharit Kundu, he has been a student of 1992, it seems. Yeah, Sharit?
Yeah, I'm highly there.
Yeah.
And I hope you can also hear me, right?
Yes, I can hear you. Please put on your video and say a few words.
I'm already
he has been a great patron He supported us in our Platinum Jubilee event of the college, and all the time we call him. He delivers lectures for the induction program of first years, and wherever we approach him, is very helpful. And let us hear something from Sharit, please.
Yeah. So first of all, my sincere thanks to you, Rituda, for giving me this opportunity to talk to all of you. Second thing, I'm really missing this particular event of today. Jeta amra proti bochor shobar sathe sakhate, we are so much engrossed in the face-to-face discussions, meeting, and a friendly chat whole through the day for the last so many years. Eta shebare we are really missing, but at the same time, we took all the advantage of the technology to ensure that we are not disconnected, and we continue our journey of association and attachment in whichever electronic way or the digital way as the situation has compelled us to do so. So having said this, I think this alumni of ours, this is one of the main binding means the bondage, the bond between all of us. Even after leaving college so many years ago, we never feel as a separate entity. Means we are so much attached together. Ikhani the role comes for the versatility of this particular alumni association, jeta shobai ke ajke amader ke dhore rekheche, bedhe rekheche, and they are making us so much closely feel that we are not lost in the industrial crowds, which normally happens in a life after the education and the college. The age attachment, amar mone hoy, the way it has been leveraged, that is extremely beneficial for us primarily, so that we are also in touch with everything. And at the same time, I'm sure a association theke we can also benefit to whatever extent possible our institute, our existing students, and all the students who are going to come forward in the future. So these small words from myself, and we are all talking of the pandemic, the difficult times, but I'm sure kono difficult times is also giving us some limelights to do something different. And we have seen many outbreaks of a lot of innovations in this period. আমার মনে হয় আমাদের সঙ্গী সাথী বন্ধু বান্ধব ভাই দাদা যারা বোন দিদিরা সবাই আছে এই কলেজ থেকে আছে বেরিয়েছে এক্সিস্টিং তারাও আবার নতুন করে কিছু করে দেখাবে সো দ্যাটস ইট অ্যান্ড থ্যাংকস টু দিস অর্গানাইজিং কমিটি উইদাউট হুজ টায়ারলেস এফোর্ট এই পার্টিকুলার ইভেন্টটা আজকে হয়তো সম্ভব হতো না সো দোজ আর অল দ্য ইনপুটস ফ্রম মাই সাইড অ্যান্ড থ্যাংক ইউ অল অফ ইউ
Thank you, Sharit. Thank you for your kind words, and also experiencing the events earlier. Also, you had the fascinating experience. So thank you very much. I'm seeing on screen Atanu Ranjan Pal of 1990. Oh, Atanu had been so nice, so friendly. So though some 8 years junior to me, but these people were much friendly with me when I joined in 1985 and 88, and they came one by one, so passed out in 1990. So we had a not exactly a teacher student relationship, we had a really like friendly relationship with them. So to talk of very few, like Dr. Subhashish Bosu Majumdar of 88 batch, Pradyut Majumdar, who just expired, I feel so sorry for him. He was 88, just 3 years junior to me. Now Atanu, he is in Tata Steel, and always has been helping us. See, amake to bibhinno der onushtane jamai ador kore giye Tata Steel er guest house e rekhe program ye korte niye jay. Ekta telephone call e amar 7ta chhele ke training dicche Tata Steel. So I am so happy to say all this. Amra Atanu kache theke kichu shuni. Atanu.
Good. So this is a different time. So always people like to meet face to face and enjoy. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Nice.
Challenge is that maybe the tomorrow this will be the new normal, and as Sudarshan was talking that she could join because it was in a virtual mode, so many of our friends, colleagues will be there, which is difficult for them to physically present in a normal our alumni meet. So really we need to rethink how we package these two things together. I was just thinking of the few idea that we are doing it, for example, this alumni talk or chat or what you call. So can we create too many breakout room? First breakout room can be batch wise. Second breakout room can be year wise. So the people find a meaning why they will join that breakout group. And if you really organize that way and everyone has a role to play, then this number, I think, can go. Now I can see there are 75 participants to much, much more. And even if maybe the present students also like to use this forum to connect many of our seniors. So I'll request all of you to think, because it's not that this year we are doing it in a virtual mode. So how really package is better whenever we'll also be doing it in a normal mode. Because what will happen is there are 150 to 200 interested alumni. They normally come and meet. But we really need to think that how we can create a system where the new people join and they also have a role to play. For example, I am joining here because I have a role to play. So many of people only should not will not join or just to listen. So we have to create a role for 1,000 people, and I think then we will getting an audience of 1,000, and that's the basic purpose to create this association so that everyone gets some more benefit out of it. Thank you.
Riduda, I have a point. Riduda, hello.
Yes, yes.
Good afternoon to all. Yes. As suggested by Atubuda, we are also available on YouTube. We are doing the live streaming. So I think some of the students or other audience have migrated to that platform. And it is giving a very clear broadcasting of this live show. So for that, I think the traffic is less here. And if there are some constraints, so it will be a learning for us also for the next session.
Yeah. Thank you, Jaideep. Thank you.
A lot of effort to make it happen. But only thing is that in this new normal, how new process we adopt. So just think of a different other way people are engaging people.
That's right. Okay. Sure. We'll definitely search for such opportunities so that more and more participation can be there. So let me proceed further. So I am seeing on screen Sharup Chand Mukhopadhyay, Sharup Da of 1980 batch. Sharup Da, please put on your video and unmute yourself and say a few words. Share with us. Sharup Da. Sharup Chand Mukhopadhyay was in Bokaro Steel, refractory department, head of the refractory department. And he has been very close to many of our, my batchmates also, as I could gather. Sharup Da. Yes, please unmute yourself, Sharup Da. It seems your video is on. Sharup Da, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, we can hear you also. So put your video on. I think it's on. Can anyone everyone see Sharup Mukherjee? Devarati, is he visible?
He is not visible, but his sound is coming.
Okay. Sharup Da, please say something. I think there is some network issue, so the bandwidth may be a little bit lower.
ধন্যবাদ দারুণ ব্যাপারটা হয়েছে ফিজিক্যালি যখন করা যায় তার কন্টিনিউটি হিসেবে ভালোই হয়েছে এবং আমাদের আরও যারা এক্সপ্লোরেন্ট প্রচুর আছে যাদের আমাদের এর সাথে কানেক্টেড না তাদের কানেক্ট করতে হবে আমাদের আর ফিজিক্যালিও বললো সেটাও আমাদের করার চেষ্টা করছি
Okay, sure.
And we have to play more and more meaningful.
Okay, Sharup Da. ঠিক আছে. Thank you. Sharup Da ke দেখা গেল না, maybe network issues এর জন্য. ঠিক আছে, আমরা Sharup Da কাছ থেকে শুনলাম. আমি on screen দেখতে পাচ্ছি আমাদের সঙ্গে just immediate past working president, Shonkho Chatterjee, the very famous name, last symposium organized, the only, almost single-handedly he handled all the major issues. Shonkho, are you there? Shonkho, please unmute and put on your video and talk something. Shonkho, because already there, so I should not lose the opportunity to hear from you.
Thank you very much. It will take me some time because I am seeing in a different screen. So switching on video will take some time. So I'll avoid that one. So nice talking to all of you.
And we enjoyed the morning session of Colonel Sengupta's talking and then our internal exchanges. It is very nice. And we look forward in the second half to other lectures. As you know, listening Colonel Sengupta's lecture, after that blood pressure increases, so dil mange more. So obviously we did our previous four events very satisfactorily, and I think what Ridda also mentioned, that financial supports and these things for college events or alumni related events were not an issue previously also, and we all hope that in future also it will not be such critical issues. Last occasions, every time we got the supports and we have funds excess. So and the most critical part is that to make the event successful, like this year also, we need at least 5 soldiers and few captains like you, Prashant Dada, Sharva Pida, now to guide. And these 5 soldiers have to act, take the responsibility for 2-3 years very actively. Don't get disheartened. That is one of my learning. And we need to encourage within our passing out year or within our organization, other alumni who are not active to part of the system and get engaged. Maybe in future, because Colonel was showing some slides and I was noting something, that so I want to add 1-2 minutes my understanding that this is new normal, obviously, but we have to be ready for many such future abnormalities. And the immunity of the body will help, like it is helping in corona pandemic. The immunity of the body will help us to sustain all of us. Now, if we see it in a different context, this is the character, which is basically built majorly at home through parents and then at school and colleges. After that, it will rest of the life span, it will just carry forward. You cannot change that character, correct? So if we as alumni association, if we in future days, if we can take up some sort of activities or workshops on character building and self-belief improvements, that will be very nice, because that will take things forward in future years and days to come. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Shonkho. Thank you, because you had the organizing power, and you last time you so nicely organized this thing. So you can give us some light so that we can proceed further in organizing in a more beautiful manner. So,
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks, Shonkho. I'd like to have with us Mr. Kollol Pal. Quite senior to us, but Kollolda is a very enthusiastic member of the Alumni Association, takes part in all activities. Kollolda, are you there? Please say yes. 1 or 2 minutes for us. Kollolda.
Let me congratulate the organizer and also our Alumni Association for organizing this type of webinar in this pandemic situation also. Now, After going through these last 2 hours, I feel that this type of webinar with a single speaker can be organized a little bit frequently, maybe after once in 3 months, 2 or 3 months. So a continuous touch between the alumni who could not join now, again after 2 months they can join, so that interaction between all the alumni can be done, because in the same single maybe may not be possible, just like your physical. Think that emotional touch little bit less, because as Devesh has told, let us, everybody should hug each other by physical. Then only emotion of alumni meet, I'm not telling technical, alumni meet may be successful. In your future, as decided earlier in the month of May, it is possible to hold a physical seminar with a webinar facility for all the internationally who are living abroad or who may not be able to participate. And I hope the next second half seminar will be successful. Thank you, Ritu. Thank you all.
Okay, thank you, Kalamla. Thank you for your suggestion. আমি অন স্ক্রিন দেখতে পাচ্ছি অনন্যা সাহা, অনন্যা জুনিয়র এবং একদমই বলবো যে রিসেন্ট ডে পাস আউট, তো অনন্যা আমাদের সঙ্গে রয়েছে। তো অনন্যা একটুখানি তুমি কিছু বলো, সো পুট ইউর ভিডিও অন, আনমিউট ইউর সেলফ অ্যান্ড টক সামথিং। অনন্যা সাহা 2012 ব্যাচ। Yes, put your video on so that everyone can see you. Yes, Anunna.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, but not visible. Yeah, no. You are not visible, rather. Okay. You talk. I think you to be bandwidth problematic.
Hello.
Yes. Please continue. Yes.
Good afternoon to everyone, and thank you, sir, and thank you to the organizing committee for arranging this kind of webinar. This is the fifth GCCT alumni meet, which is being celebrated in very much different way, which is the new normal way. And I must say that the theme is very much appropriate, because definitely we are reconnecting, restoring, and reinvigorating the GCCT spirits. So, okay, we could not meet in person like previous years. At least we are seeing each other's face in this rectangle. Unfortunately, the poor virus gave us ample time to stress ourselves out, make ourselves bored and confined to the four walls, whoever is staying wherever. So definitely we deserve some refreshment, some humor, and of course some motivation, which we already got some motivation after Cornel Sengupta's speech, and definitely Dil Mange More. So till then, stay tuned, stay safe, wear mask, and definitely all of us, I am sure all of us would like to meet in person like every year we do.
You have so unmuted.
Can be done depending on the situation. So enjoy the rest of the day and stay safe.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you, Anunna. Thank you very much for sharing your views. And now I would like to call Deepankar Banerjee. Deepankar Banerjee of 1994, I think. He is with Vesuvius. He has joined in the morning. I have also I had some few words regarding some other businesses with our students. So Deepankar, can you share some views? Because he had been a patron and he joined earlier alumni meet had the panelist in some of the discussions. Is Dipankar there? So I think he's in the list of attendees. So can I?
Rituda, you can connect Manomendra.
Yes, Manomendra. Yes. Okay. Let's hear from Manomendra. Manom.
Yes, Rituda.
Yes, Manomendra. Please share your views. Yeah. So another very highly enthusiastic student, Manomendra, had been very close to us in Manomendra is 1991 batch. So when I visited Bahrain some 2 to 3 times due to some training program in Elba, and where my friend used to work, Manomendra, Indrajit, they all used to drive from Saudi Arabia to my friend's house, Asim's house, and to have adda in the weekend. So we had so nice time. All 2 or 3 times they had been there. So so close a relationship. And Manomendra has been very nice, so that he sponsored some of our present students to the event, contributing from his pocket to the alumni event. And he joined some of the earlier sessions also. So let us hear from Manomendra something. Manom.
Yes, thank you, first of all. Good afternoon to teachers, my seniors, friends, my sisters and brothers. Thank you, Rituda, and organizing committee for giving me this opportunity to speak few words. As you know, physically I'm far away from India, and because of pandemic I could not travel for last few months, but still we are managing here, we are safe. Actually college made us the person who we are today professionally. Therefore, as alumni, it is our responsibility to build and grow the brand and profile of college globally. However, after college life, we get scattered and often disconnected with college friends. But this kind of meeting, networking, and engagement is a great initiative from your side to build and maintain relationship with the college, present students, ex-students. Thanks to all the association members and organizing committee for helping us to come together and discuss, share common issues related to all. So I'll not take much issues. Actually, I get a lot of requests from my college students and seniors, even my friends, to job opportunity in the petrochemical industries, particularly oil industries. As you know, mostly we are associated with traditional ceramic refractory manufacturing, then metal industries, cement, glass. But if somebody wants to work in the petrochemical industries, refractory knowledge is not enough. There are many other ceramic applications, and that we don't discuss either in the college and this kind of meeting. Like, there is a lot of insulation materials. We call it hot insulation, cold insulation, acoustic insulation. There are a lot of chemical resistance lining materials. Those are not high temperature, but all ceramic materials. Then we have fire protection. Then we have high temperature coating. So if somebody wants to work in the petrochemical industry, so he has to understand all these requirements, then only the employment possibilities are there. Regarding alumni, I think you people are doing a great job, and we have earlier also discussed many things and areas of improvement. I think as a team, we can do many things and create an impact, but we have to be more proactive and initiate some value-added tasks in addition to these common activities. Like we can make some subcommittee within our group, like one committee on refractory, one committee on glass and cement. So there could be possibilities of regular engagement between these committee members, and this committee can be headed by some of our ex-senior alumni. And at the end, we can discuss some common areas, concerns, areas of improvement, and we can publish some technical report. I think that will give opportunity to have regular engagement with the team.
Joydeep, please make a note of it, that whatever he is suggesting, please make a note so that we can amend our, whatever comes out from the meeting, can take note of it. Okay, thank you, Manavendra. Thank you for sharing your views. I'm seeing on screen Dipankar. Dipankar has joined. So please, Dipankar Banerjee of Vesuvius. So please share a few words with us.
Yes, sir. Is my voice audible now?
Yes, yes. Fantastic. Yes.
Yeah, actually, sorry, I was not able to activate the video earlier. And thanks for this opportunity also, because like all the speakers have told, I mean, in this situation, I think this was the best alternative. And going forward, like Atunuda was also telling, this might become a new way where more people can join in, and maybe in a live session also, face to face, if we can have an option where some of the attendees from far away who are not able to be physically present in that session also can join through some video link or audio link. A combination of these two can be worked out in the next session. I think that's a very good idea. And taking cue from Professor Dr. Krishnendu Chakraborty in his speech, I think it is happening sporadically, but a structured partnership between industry with our alumni and the college, I think that is required, because many of us get busy in the regular jobs, and but in a structured way, like online lectures, some workshops, or maybe some work which can be offloaded to the college lab, maybe on chargeable basis, some such projects. I think it is time that maybe few of us can get together and discuss and formalize. And secondly, like you said, in this time also, the in-factory training has started. And in fact, although it is a bit late, but I think still there is still some 1 or 2 months time when some implant training from some of our companies can be organized. And just to say that even although it is it got delayed, but we are trying in Vesuvius Calcutta plant also some training. This year it was difficult in Vizag, we could not do, but I think better late than never. In-plant training can never replace online training, so I think that's something we need to, maybe all of us can come together and put some more effort. Students who are not yet been exposed to industrial training this year, so that's my appeal to the other alumni. And that's all from my side. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Dipankar. Thank you for being with us, sharing your views. And now request Sumit. Sumit, please invite some of the noted ITCAC alumni who must be waiting to say something. Sumit, can you coordinate those people? After that, some of the people were not getting. I am having with me Bashok Bandopadhyay and Mita Bandopadhyay, who had shifted to IT and computer science, like management fields, and who were interested to talk, but they couldn't get the link. I have just now sent. But in the meantime, Sumit, can you invite some people? I am seeing Debashish Pal. He can say something, and also your friends. So invite people to talk something regarding this. Sumit, please. Debashish, I think Debashish Pal is there. Debashish Pal, can you say something? Debashish Pal, he has been putting on his video on this thing. I was seeing him in the panel. So Debashish Pal from computer science. So please reflect some light on our alumni activities and how to improve upon it. Are you there, Debashish?
I think he's also not there, Ritika.
He's also not there. So
maybe we move to the two videos.
Two videos, yeah. By that time, if these people can join, I have sent to Bashab and Mita. They are waiting. They could not get to the link, I think. So if they are available, then please make them panelists. And by that time, let us move to Gautam Bhardwaj's this live video, live session, and Shobhoshati's live session. Please, Sharmapi, please coordinate this.
Okay. Yeah. Supriyo, requesting to start the screen share and the video.
Yes, let us mute ourselves so that. Sound, please.
Okay, we cannot hear the sound.
No, we are not able to hear the sound. Let us explain what he has done. He has developed that area of Dibrugarh near to his native place, it seems, to a very nice tourist spot, this Kanchenjunga floating restaurant. So he has made it, and it's a beautiful touring spot, and he has, in his own effort, has made it possible. So other than doing some other social work also, making roads through his own investment, so he's doing all this kind of social work also. So he had his own business, he resources, he recruited some people from our college also. So now he's concentrating on these areas also. So let us have the video. Some problem was there. I just told you, I shared with you the background behind this. But let us see the video, what it is all about.
Ritu, if it is not workable,
yes,
then we can move on to the
Sobhasachi's.
We can move to second up those videos.
We can do that.
Yeah, yep. And we also have to stick to the time, whatever slot we have given. So yeah. Please take care of that.
Yes, yes. Time. I think time is up. Almost time is we are up to one. I think the time was.
So Rishuda, I think it is a good idea. We will shift the video in the beginning of post lunch session.
Yes, post lunch session, and the remaining people who could not log in and distinct that. Yes, Manishekar Jha is there. I think Manishekar is there. Can you, Mani, can you unmute yourself and say something? Manishekar just messaged me just 1 second ago. So, Manishekar Jha from Oman, Al Nada Group, he is a recruiter. He has been a great patron for our administration, now the vice president also. Mani, can you put forward your views? He is saying that he has joined.
Yeah, he has joined, but he has not been made panelist, so he cannot unmute.
Oh, okay.
So I think what we can do is that if Supriyo can make him panelist right now, then he can share. Otherwise, we will do it in the second round of Voice of Alumni, in the second round.
Okay.
Supriyo is trying to make him panelist. Otherwise, just wait for a few seconds, then we'll move on to the second half.
Okay, let us see. Is Probal Dash here? Probal Dash, Arup Ghosh, Arup Ghosh, Probal Dash. Anyone of you present?
I think Ritu.
Yeah. Okay. Let us then move to the second half. Yeah.
Yeah. We can conclude it because lot of our alumni members who are eager to tell their views.
Yes.
We can do it in the second half in a more structured way.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So now let us.
And also, also ask Sumit also to invite some more people of ITCSE. so that they can also share their views in the second half, because they might not be available during office hours today. So, okay. So, attendees, please have a break for lunch, and we will sharp start at 2:30. Start at 2:30. Meet in at 2:30. So till then, bye bye.
Thank you so much for the wonderful session, sir. It was a very nice coordination from your end. This is how we are ending on the first half of event, and we will be meeting once again for the post lunch session sharp at 2:30. And a small announcement, once remind you all that we are live streaming at our YouTube channel, GCCT's YouTube channel. Please check out the live session there and please be connected with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Devaruthi. So we are closing the first session now, and we will meet again at 2:30 with the deliberations of the second half, with Mr. Bobby D'Souza speaking, with Dr. Krishnendu's performance and all. So we have already shared with you the our program details. We'll have Voice of Alumni second session also, in which whom we missed in the first session will add up in the second session with the video streaming of Gautam Bardoloi and Shambhu Sathi Ray. So thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you all.